Welcome back everyone. This is the part 2 of Nuke optimization series. So in this one we will going to see how to optimize better, make your Nuke script file size smaller also. That is the thing, another big thing you need to consider. You always make sure your Nuke file size is smaller as much as you can. So as you can see on my screen, we will going to optimize these three steps now. First thing is like we need to remove whatever the unwanted nodes we have in our node graph, and also the channels we need to remove. And the second thing, if you are using any node that is there is an option called GPU enable, so this option will be there, so you need to make sure you check the box, because when you're using a GPU it's always faster to render and also for a preview purpose. And the third thing is we need to control the node effect, so I will explain this what I mean. So let's see the first one. I have here a small script just for demonstration purpose, so you can easily see the first thing, we need to remove whatever unwanted nodes and the channels. It's very obvious, we need to remove whatever the unwanted nodes we have in the entire node graph. If you are not using anything, just remove it, because it will reduce your Nuke file size. This is the comp optimized version 1. So this file is storing in my hard drive, so the file size will increase if you have many nodes and if you're not using it. So keep it smaller as much as you can in your Nuke file. Now you can see it's clean. So the next step we need to, as we are seeing here, the channels, we need to remove the channels that we are not using. So you can see in the plate, obviously we don't have anything because it's just a plate and it's RGBA. If you need alpha you can keep it, otherwise just add a remove the extra channels. Like in this situation, the plate, if you don't need, just select RGBA and the alpha will remove. But you can see we have a CG here, right? So in the CG one, we get many passes, but in this example I just made a normal depth and position pass just to show you what I mean. So if you merge here till here, you're not gonna see any pass because all the channels is in this A pipe. So if you want here, you can go in the merge and you can also merge whatever the path you need in your output file. But in this situation we don't need anything. This is very simple setup, but you can imagine we have defocus and all those things and we are carrying these passes through the end of the pipe, which is not good at all. After you are doing CG correction and all those things using those utility passes and all those beauty diffuse color and all those passes, just remove it. So in the first part I explain in the CG thing, once you shuffle everything you just need to add a remove node. Do that first, and after this one if you using like ZD focus thing, we need a depth pass. So we have a depth pass here, a normal pass and position pass. Once you use that, make sure, I'm just disabling this one, make sure you add a remove and kill everything except whatever you need. So in this situation I need RGBA because I need alpha. So in the end you should have your remove node here, so you can merge with this one or you can do a precomp here. So if you do a precomp here, your precomp will be here, and your precomp only contain the whatever channel you selected. Like I need RGBA for example, or I need a normal pass. Okay, so these things I need, so I am going to render in precomp and then I will merge with my plate. So this is the second thing you need to consider, you need to keep in mind. Make sure you remove whatever the unwanted node you have in your node graph. And the second thing is remove channels, whatever channels is required, just keep them and remove everything. So this video will be very short because the first part I explain almost everything, and whatever the I explained in the first part, it's all applied here also, the crop and all those things what I explained in the previous part, in the part 1. Now you can see we need to use GPU enable nodes. So in the Nuke, if you open, so these are the three nodes I added here. These are the most common use we are using. Obviously the ZD focus, if you see use GPU, make sure you use this because it will eventually speed up your preview and it will reduce your render time also. And the chrono, see, these are the nodes we are mostly using for retime and for defocus. And if you are using any third party node, like if you are using a PXF node, if you are using PXF ZD focus, you also have this thing here. Make sure you are use this one. If you have a chance to use GPU, you always use GPU. Third thing is, this is the control nodes channel. So this thing is very, very, very interesting, and we need to pay attention this one, because if you're not managing this thing properly, your Nuke will slow, very slow, and render will take longer time to render. your render will take longer time. So what I mean by that, so imagine, see, this is the CG, so this is the Bex example I can show you, or otherwise I will show you the full script so you will see what I mean by this thing. So again, in this one I will use this comp to show you what I mean controlling channel in nodes. You can see we have this nice fire and this is the entire comp. So if you want to know more about this comp, I have a full video. You can check the video about how I comp this entire fire thing. So let's see. If you see here, I have this fire, right? And you can see I have many layers. You can see the fire element itself we have, the mask I have, and the mats. These are two mats I have, and these are the fire element itself, and these are the RGB, and this is the fire element. I'm coming here, you can see I have this defocus, right? So if you take any defocus like blur and ZD focus, now in those nodes you can see in every node we see we have this channel option here. So this indicate which channel we want to affect this by this node. In my situation I have many channels here, right? The mask and fire and all those. So let's see if I plug this blur here, and by default I'm blurring this thing. And if I check my other channel also, you can see my fire also, my fire element, the layer itself also get blur, because here by default saying all channels. You can see I can control the channel which I want to affect by this node. So this is what I mean. Imagine I'm just want to affect the RGBA. So you can see my fire element and all other element will not gonna get affected, only this RGBA. And here we can see it. If you set all or fire element only, the blur will only apply to this channel, the fire layer itself only. So this is what I mean. So similarly in the grid also, if you place here and if I just select fire element and if I create this fire element like crazy like this, see the RGBA is not gonna affect, RGBA will not gonna get affected because we have set it. And you can see in the grid itself is saying fire element, so we can know, so we know which layer we are affecting with this grid. So the similarity you can see in this defocus, I set it to all because I want to affect all. When you're doing a full CG comp, make sure you select this option. So we will see in this CG also, you can see I have this full CG render. If I view it here, you can see how many passes and all those things I have here. So we can see currently I'm only carrying the depth pass and the position pass. And if I show you the actual render, so this is the render, right? This one. This is the render and I have all those passes. So let's see, imagine I want to affect the diffuse direct. So I can add grade or I can add blur, and I can go here and I can select my pass and I can easily blur this pass only. And I can do, so I can do like this. See, now here the diffuse direct is normal. I graded the diffuse normal, diffuse direct, and then blur it channel itself. So by default this thing is setting to all. That means you are blurring everything. So all these channels, and Nuke is calculating all those channels in the background, which is not good at all. So make sure if you add any node like blur or 3D focus, make sure you select what channel you want to affect and only use those channels, and remove unwanted channel before doing defocus, before adding blur and everything. So make sure you do that. See here, I set it here alpha, and here in this I can set only alpha because I know this, I only need to blur the alpha. You can see the cryptomat is carrying everything. I can go here and I can set alpha only, alpha for this, for the mask. I can set here only. So like that, you need to make sure you are controlling which channel you are affecting using a node, using any node in Nuke. So this is the thing I want to share, and you see my precomp here. So this is the final precomp. You can see the I'm carrying position and depth pass, and if I want I can control them where they are located. This is the thing I want to share. Make sure whatever the I explained the part one, you can follow that. And this part two is very simple. There is only three things you need to consider. Remove unwanted nodes and channels in your node graph. Make it clean. You can see the, how clean this script is. I don't have any floating nodes and anywhere else in the script. Make sure you remove channels before doing precomp and before rendering final output. And the second thing is, make sure you use GPU enable nodes. If you have a GPU, if you have a powerful GPU and the node itself is supporting, make sure you enable that in the first. Last thing is, just like I show you now, check the node, check the channels in your pipe, and the blur and the defocus, these are the most common nodes we are using. Make sure you select which channel you want to affect. Don't affect all the channels, it will slow your system down. and your render performance also. So make sure you do that and you are good to go. So I hope you learned something from all those optimization tips. So in the next week I have one CG comp which I will share. I did some CG comp on a live plate, so I will be sharing what I did and how I did. Obviously I will also share the CG render itself, so you can do a practice with them. So again, thank you for watching. Make sure you watch the part one and then continue with this part two. Thank you for watching. We will see you in every next one. Have a great day.